Good evening from Washington, D.C., and thank you to those of you joining us from around the world for news from a Catholic perspective. I'm Lauren Ashburn. President Trump calls a group of Catholic high school students from Kentucky symbols of fake news and how evil it can be. The Covington Catholic classmates attended the March for Life in Washington, D.C. last week before they were swept up in a national controversy sparked by a viral video. White House correspondent Mark Irons reports from the school at the center of the debate in Park Hills, Kentucky, near Cincinnati. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Lauren. Covington Catholic High School behind me has its doors locked. Classes were canceled today. You see the police car right behind me blocking the entrance. It's all because of security concerns. Administrators here have been coping with backlash after Friday's incident. Now, at the nearby diocesan headquarters, there was a protest today, and we're learning more about an incident that just blew up on social media.
This is the video that sparked so much outrage. At first glance, it appears Covington Catholic High School student Nick Sandman and his classmates were disrespecting a Native American drummer at the Lincoln Memorial. But other videos paint a much more complex picture. Members of the Black Hebrew Israelite movement first shouted racist slurs at the students wearing Make America Great Again hats. That's when Native American Nathan Phillips says he started banging his drum to diffuse tensions. The convergence of the three different groups was all caught on camera. President Trump tweeted, "Looking like Nick Sandman and his Covington Catholic students were treated unfairly with early judgments, proving out to be false. Smeared by media, not good, but making big comeback." The boys' representative in Congress, Thomas Massey, also sent a tweet saying, "Thank you, real Donald Trump, for supporting our Covington Catholic students." Representative Massey added on Facebook, "The honorable and tolerant students of Covington Catholic School came to D.C. to advocate for the unborn and to learn about our nation's capital. What they got was a brutal lesson in the unjust court of public opinion and social media mobs." President Trump says he knows the Catholic school students will turn this experience into something positive. He tweets, "It started off unpleasant, but can end in a dream."
Despite the encounter in D.C. and the emotions that followed it, the incident never became violent, but still threats of violence attracted a police presence here today outside Covington Catholic. So, Lauren, we'll be paying attention to see if the doors here open back up tomorrow.
White House correspondent Mark Irons reporting from Park Hills, Kentucky. Thank you, Mark.